Well, if you have already planted, don't worry. Luann Aiken with Sagawa Garden Center, help us protect our vegetation.
First of all, the good news, if you have planted trees, shrubs, perennials, and they're growing in your yard, no problem. They're going to handle this weather just fine. If you have planted annuals, they may well need some protection. There are a lot of things you can do. If you have an empty cardboard box, put it over that, protect it with plastic, you're good to go. Laundry baskets, drums of nursery pots, anything that can make an inverted bubble. And that's our goal, is to catch some of the warmth from the soil, especially if it's on the ground. But these urns like this are going to do well too. What we have here is a handy dandy non-gardening piece of rebar, which can be a gardener's best friend in hail and in cold weather. So we're going to take this, we're going to put it down in the middle of our container. And if, in effect, we're making a tent stake, a nice tent mound, a frame. You're gonna help me with this. This is frost cloth. It will hold maybe an extra 3 to 4 degrees. I'm gonna bundle that around there. It's nice and light because of that rebar. We're not weighing anything down. And if you can, and this is really important, put some plastic over it. You wanna keep the fabric dry, because wet fabric, wet sheets, wet blankets are going to actually pull some heat out of that, just with the process of attempted evaporation. So if there is something you need to do to protect, there's so many ways to do it. Just look at the things in your house that aren't necessarily what you would use them for normally. Waste baskets make great. I don't think we're going to have any wind, so weigh it down if you do see wind in the forecast. But otherwise, protect them, love them a couple days from what you're saying, Chris, and we should be good to go.